Children bawled, and one Halloween night, Stormy and Cold, too much candy from their neighbors they did take. It is known that their greed set their fate. All the village's treats they did amass, except one last house, whose gates no one would pass. To this spooky old mansion the craving children went, to the last of the town's candy. They were fast on its scent. Along a path of shattered slate they cautiously walked, greeted by cawing ravens in the black cat that stalked. Clang, 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 the cauldron-shaped doorknocker rang. Creak, 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 the giant oak door slowly swung. Standing before him was the cutest child, almost their age. With a new fiancée, he invited them into his magnificent Victorian cage. To his parlor they followed, where an enormous mound of sweet treats they did greet. The children dared to ask.
I took it from the good townspeople. 'Twas quite a task.
He offered, presenting a tattered old sack. Several pieces they took smelled and tasted, but moments later they began to gag and hack. And the children cried,
"We might have a sugar and flung the lips into a small bowl."
"I'm not surprised,"
the boy said,
"as our school knew,
the bell herself. The children's vows again, they did fear. What is this boy thing standing apart far too near? And for the first time he did smile, exposing teeth yellow, pointed, and vile.
"In the week goes by, no share my light. I live in your fortune, an eternal light."
The thick doors groaned loudly, and slowly began to shut. The children raced for their freedom, faster than any hunter's hungry mutt. What of their fate? Did they escape? No one knows, but have no fear. At least the town's candy is safe, and shall never again disappear.